Hi, my name is Iromi Pereira, and in this series of imagining how Sri Lanka should change if we get a chance to rebuild after the pandemic, I will be talking about reimagining urban development. I like to think through this idea in two ways. First, through the idea of shelter, and then the idea of equitable cities that reflects the needs and aspirations of its citizens. As we've seen during this pandemic curfew period, things like hand washing, social distancing, and the idea of home being the safest place is a luxury for many, especially for the working class poor. If we have the opportunity to rethink our current housing situation, we should be supporting working class communities to self-build and improve their housing in situ. We will build adequate and affordable housing for renters, for migrant workers, and build shelters for the homeless. Access to water and sanitation in housing and community spaces will be given a high priority. And we will not have high-rise complexes being built for the urban poor, where at times like this, they're trapped in small apartments with little ventilation and sunlight. The idea is basically for the built environment to be reimagined to include more spaces for home gardens, community spaces, and areas for children to play, and definitely more and more green spaces. In working towards more equitable cities, we should also do away with clearly what we don't need and will not cripple a country at a time like this. Here I'm talking about the world-class city ideas that have dominated our urban development and infrastructure planning post-war. For example, do we need thousands of high-end condominiums coming up in Colombo or being planned for cities like Trincomalee? Do we need world-class aquariums and seafront promenades that are being planned for Marine Drive? Do we want to continue to take apart our cities and make them into a replica of Singapore and Dubai? Hasn't this time period showed us that that is not the need of the hour? And coupled with the reality of climate change, we really need to rethink this current approach. With so many job cuts and pay cuts across the world during COVID-19 lockdowns, and for us following a year after the Easter attacks, we've seen firsthand how unexpected events drastically affect our country. So then why do we continue in the same vein without taking into account how each calamity that we face, from drought to terror attacks to pandemics, have altered our lives and the way we do things forever? And then not take those lessons into making changes in our built environment and infrastructure to make us more resilient in the future. We should take this opportunity to reimagine our cities and urban planning by thinking about how we can make our lives better had XYZ infrastructure been in place or space had been a reality at a time like this. Over the last few weeks, people have been sharing videos of how clear the Colombo skies are or how you can see Adam's Peak. And this says a lot about the air quality and the daily pollution in our cities. We should also then take this opportunity to reimagine Sri Lanka's public transport system and making it one that is not only more affordable and accessible to everyone, but that one that is a lot more connected and will get people to where they want to go faster. And this would also enable us to more efficiently plan adequate and housing and sustainable housing in a manner that I spoke about earlier. So the idea is that we are not adding more and more concrete needlessly to our cities, and instead plan spaces that reflect what we as a country need to be more resilient, not just economically, but also reflecting the well-being and aspirations of all its citizens. Thank you.